In our airways, the air we breathe comes into contact with a mixture of different types of healthy respiratory cells. Some respiratory cells have cilia, hair-like structures that move the mucus along. These ciliated cells in our airways are the main target for the SARS-CoV-2 coronavirus. The virus itself is deceptively simple. It only consists of a few parts, but together these parts create a highly effective virus. It has an outer membrane with three types of proteins on it: spike, envelope, and membrane proteins. Inside the virus, an assembly of nucleocapsid proteins hold together its genetic material, a single strand of viral RNA. The spike protein is responsible for making contact with the host cell and starting the infection. It's glycosylated, meaning it has a coat of sugars that hides it from the body's immune system. Many of the variants of SARS-CoV-2 are characterized by mutations on this spike protein that can influence its function, some making the virus more infectious. Many of these mutations are unique to each variant, but some, like D416G, are found on each of the variants of concern. When the virus closes in on a host cell, its spike proteins open up and bind to a receptor on the host cell called ACE2. After the spike protein makes contact, furin cuts off the outer part of the spike protein, called the S1 domain. This frees the inner core of the spike protein, called the S2 domain, which is cut by TMPRSS2. The spike protein then unfolds and anchors into the host cell membrane, pulling the virus closer until the cell membrane and the viral membrane fuse, allowing the viral genome to enter the host cell. Inside the cell, a ribosome meets the viral RNA and starts to translate its genetic code. The result is a long protein chain containing non-structural proteins, or NSPs. Initially, these NSPs are all attached to one another, but some of the NSPs are able to cut the chain. NSP3 is the first one that can cleave its neighbours. It cuts and releases the first NSP, which is able to grab onto a ribosome and occupy it in such a way that the ribosome can only read viral RNA and not the host cell's own mRNA. This means that the virus takes over the cell's translation machinery, turning the host cell into a virus-building factory. Meanwhile, NSP3 cuts other neighbours before it cuts and frees itself. Eventually, the production of NSP stops because there's a pseudo-knot in the viral RNA. This prevents the remaining RNA, which codes for proteins involved in viral genome replication, from passing through the ribosome. By now, a second cutting NSP has been made, which cuts itself and its neighbours. The translation can either stop here, or the pseudo-knot in the viral RNA can slip, allowing the remaining viral RNA to be read. The second cutting NSP is now able to cut all of the remaining proteins. Because of the pseudo-knot, the translation of the viral RNA often stops prematurely. As a result, the host cell produces fewer of the RNA processing NSPs from beyond the knot than the various membrane modifying NSPs from before the pseudo-knot. The three NSPs that are embedded into the endoplasmic reticulum membrane cause it to curve. This disrupts the sheet-like shape of the ER and creates a structure called a double membrane vesicle, or DMV. These DMVs create a safe, enclosed environment for the viral genome to be copied. Inside the DMV, the newly created NSPs will become the machinery to create new viral RNA. Firstly, a complementary strand is made to act as a reference. This reference then becomes a template for a new strand identical to the original viral genome. In addition to the full-length viral genome, a set of shorter RNA strands is also created. These shorter strands are called subgenomic mRNA, and will be processed by the host cell to create the proteins that go onto the new viral particle. The subgenomic mRNA exits into the cytosol through an NSP pore in the DMV. After exiting, it makes its way back to a ribosome, and is translated to make the main proteins that will constitute the new SARS-CoV-2 viral particle, the spike, membrane, envelope, and nuclear capsid proteins. The newly created nuclear capsid protein sits right by the DMV pore, ready to grab onto the viral genome RNA as it exits the DMV. The nuclear capsid protein then begins packaging the RNA into what will become the contents of the new viral particles. After the spike, envelope, and membrane proteins have been made on the ER membrane, they go to a different membrane compartment called the ergic. On the ergic, the membrane proteins are able to catch the nuclear capsid proteins and viral genome. This makes the membrane bend inwards and a new viral particle eventually buds. When the membrane compartment containing the viral particles fuses with the outer cell membrane, the viral particles are then released from the cell. But that's only the first wave of SARS-CoV-2 particles that will be expelled. Eventually, the host cell produces so many viral particles that it dies and releases a whole wave of new virus particles into the surrounding tissue, ready to spread and infect nearby cells. This completes the life cycle of a single SARS-CoV-2 coronavirus.